Welcome students, this is Varsha, CBSE Maths 10th Standard Arithmetic Progression, Exercise 5.3. So this is question number 10 from Exercise 5.3. So students, in Exercise 5.3, there are 20 questions. So now I am going to do the 10th question, okay? So this exercise comes under algebra lesson, okay? So which lesson is this? Is Arithmetic Progression. You are more questions have from algebra, okay? So algebra lesson is important. This is one more important lesson. This is so you just try to do each and every sum with understanding. That is more important. Understanding the concept is very much important. Okay, so let's go to the sum. Show that a1, a2 and an are okay. Form an AP where an is defined as below. So you have a general term. This is called an. An is equal to 3 plus 4n, where n in natural numbers. Okay students, it means you have to substitute for small n 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so when you substitute 1, okay, so what you get? 3 plus 4 into 1. So this is 3 plus 4. So that is 7. So here you are multiplying. So what is a2? Fine. 3 plus 4 into 2. So this is 3 plus 8. So you get 11. Okay, what is a3? So this is also 3 plus 4 into 3. So this is 3 plus 12. So you get 15. So a4. So 3 plus 4 into 4. So this is 3 plus 16, okay, so this is 19. So you got so far numbers. What are the numbers? 7, 11, 15, 19 and etc. Okay, so show that this form an AP. So they want to know, we have to show that this is AP or not. So how will you say that this is AP or not? Take the difference students, A2 minus A1. And you have to verify A3 minus A2. If it is equal, you can say it is a AP. So let's find. A2 is 11 minus 4. Okay. This is A3, 15 minus 14. So this is 4. And here also 4. So that 4. These numbers form an AP. These numbers forms an AP. Okay. So we found that it is an AP. So what is the next question? That's all. N is defined as below A3 plus AN. Okay. So we found that is fine. What is that question? This is 10th question. And also find the sum of the first 15 terms of in each case. So this is your question. I have forget to write. What is your question, students? Also find the sum of first 15 terms. Okay. So we can find. Okay students, is it that much difficult? So easy. We can find the sum. So what's the sum? How will you find sum? This is S15. So what's the formula? N by 2. 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So this is our formula. So here they want to find 15 terms. So we take it as 15 by 2. Okay. So 2 into A. What's your A? First number is 7. Okay. Plus N is 15. So 15 minus 1. That is 14 into D. What is your D? D is 4. Okay. So 15 by 2. See students, this is multiplication, here it is multiplication. First you have to do this. 14, this is 56, okay. So this is 15 by 2 and this is 70, okay. So you cancel here, this is 35. So 15 into 35, the answer is 525. Okay, this is the sum of the 15 terms, okay. So this is the answer, students. Do you understand? I hope you all understand. This sum is little bit different from other sums. So what is the difference? Because he in the sum they have not given all the element in the AP. Okay, so we found the terms by giving the general term. So this is the general term they have given. We found by the general term the elements. Okay, so these are the elements. What are the elements? 7, 11, 15, 19. These are the terms. We found the terms by the general term. Okay, so finding the general term, each term is first important. Okay, every how you find, you have substitute 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and so far. So first you substitute 1 for n, then you substitute 2 for n, so and 3. So how you find, students, this is 4n, it means you have to multiply. Okay, then you can add 3. Many of the students just add and multiply, that is wrong. That what is that wrong? It is, we follow Bodmer's rule. Okay, Bodmer's rule. So that by that rule you have to multiply first, then addition. Okay, what is that Bodmer? Okay, so bracket of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. So we have to do multiplication and then addition. Okay, so last one is subtraction. So here you have multiplication and addition, so that you have to first multiplication first, then you have to add, so that you will get 7, 11, 15 and 19. These are the terms of a AP. So here the in this question they have asked, show that this is forms an AP. Very simple. A2 minus A1 and A3 minus A2, if it is equal, we can say it is an AP. So we found that, okay, the difference, common difference. So at last we concluded it is an AP. Okay, so this is form an AP, and they want to find the sum of the 15 terms. So simple, you have formula n to 15. For A 7, D for 4, that's all. You have substitute all the elements, okay, variables you substitute and you find the answer 525. This is your final answer. Okay, student, do you understand? I hope you all understand this sum. So please like and subscribe, students. Okay, thank you.